là ce soir. Alors aujourd'hui, c'est
Christmas.
No. Comment on dit en French? Comment on dit Christmas en français?
Noël.
You got it. OK. Alors ce soir, on est là pour célébrer Noël. D'accord? Donc, nous sommes l'AIT Houston, l'association des Ivoiriens du Texas de Houston. Et nous sommes très très heureux de vous avoir ce soir avec nous. Merci beaucoup d'avoir répondu aussi nombreux. Merci d'être là aussi nombreux, comme je disais. Can we give a clap for all of you guys? Woo! We better get excited. Santa Claus is on the other room over there. Maybe, depending on how you participate, we'll see if you get some gift or not. Just kidding, everybody's gonna get a gift today. Donc sans plus tarder, nous allons commencer. Donc aujourd'hui, nous sommes dans l'église, donc West Houston Vietnamese Baptist Church. Et nous avons eu vraiment la grâce et la bonne volonté donc de Pasteur Tano et de son épouse Angeline Tano de nous recevoir ici. Donc on aimerait vraiment les remercier. Est-ce qu'on peut applaudir pour Pasteur Tano et Danti, Maman Tano? Donc c'est grâce à eux que nous sommes là aujourd'hui. Et avant de commencer donc le programme, nous allons inviter notre président, Kevin Folic aussi, à nous donner un petit mot. You can clap!
Bonsoir les enfants. Vous êtes contents d'être là?
Oui.
Donc c'est English or French? All right, English. Let's do English first. All right. So kids, we're really happy to have you. This is a special moment for the association. Christmas is where we show appreciation to our kids with gifts. It's always a pleasure to have.
Est-ce que vous voulez qu'on parle de Dieu un peu? C'est Dieu qui donne les cadeaux, non? Est-ce que vous savez pourquoi il y a la Noël? Amen. Donc, restez tranquille et écoutez. Vous me donnez 5 minutes ou 10 minutes. 5 minutes comme l'heure est pressée. Mais si vous écoutez tranquillement, vous aurez les plus beaux cadeaux. Celui qui n'a pas écouté là, Dieu a les yeux partout te voir. Ton cadeau là sera petit. Ok? Alléluia.
Amen.
Mon équipe et moi, nous sommes vraiment merci. Nous sommes vraiment heureux de vous recevoir dans ce lieu.
We are very happy to receive you right here.
C'est la maison de Dieu.
In the house of the Lord.
Je dis vraiment merci à mon président, le président des Ivoiriens.
I'm saying thanks
à Houston.
To my president, the president of
merci beaucoup pour
Houston.
Ce grand combat que tu mènes.
We say thank you for the great fight you're doing.
Je dis merci à toute l'équipe qui l'accompagne.
Thanks to the whole team that's accompanying him.
Je voudrais dire merci aux serviteurs, aux servantes de Dieu qui sont présents ici. Je vous en prie.
I would like to say thank you to the servants of God that are here.
Je parle parce que je suis un serviteur de Dieu et je suis dans la maison de Dieu. Avant toute chose, je pense qu'il faut confier cela à Dieu.
I'm saying like this because I'm the servant of God and we are here in the house of the Lord. So before everything, we have to offer everything to God first.
Voici mon équipe. Là, yes. Et Pasteur Savoy qui travaille ici avec nous.
Here is my team and also Pastor Savoy, I myself who's working together with him right here.
Nous allons prier.
We're gonna pray.
Et juste donner deux petits mots pour vous encourager aussi.
Just in two words. Just
pour vous dire que
you.
Dieu est ici, il a les yeux ici, il vous voit, il vous aime.
To make you know that God is here and He's here and seeing you.
Père, nous te bénissons.
Father, we thank you.
Nous te rendons toute la gloire.
We give you glory.
Père, voici toute cette famille, les familles qui sont réunies ici et tous ces enfants devant toi.
Here is the families gathered before you, God.
Papa, tu connais toutes choses.
Father, you know everything.
Et tu connais leur avenir.
And you know their future.
Ce soir, papa, tu sers.
This evening, Father, you know.
Que sans toi, rien ne peut être construit.
Without you, nothing can be built.
C'est pour cette raison, difficulté pour venir.
Bless them even in their lives, in their future.
Seigneur,
Father,
sois ici.
Be here.
À la première place.
First of all.
Remplis ce lieu de ton esprit saint.
Fill this place with your power.
Protège tous ces enfants par ton sang, le sang de ton fils Jésus.
Protect all children with the blood of your son Jesus Christ.
Et que tout esprit qui ne glorifie pas ton nom dans ces lieux,
that all kind of spirit that does not glorify your name,
soit complètement anéanti au nom de Jésus.
May be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus.
Mets la joie dans le cœur de tout un chacun.
But the joy in the heart of everybody.
En sortant d'ici,
when we go out of this,
qu'ils soient tous remplis de ta joie et de ton Saint-Esprit.
They may be filled with your joy and that's in the spirit.
Merci papa pour ta présence.
Thank you Father for your presence.
Au nom de Jésus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Vous savez, on ne peut pas parler de Noël sans parler de l'amour de Dieu.
You know, we cannot talk about Christmas without talking about the love of God.
Et nous connaissons tous le fameux chapitre 3 de Jean chapitre 3 verset 16.
And we know all about John chapter 3 verse 16.
Qui dit Dieu a tant aimé.
That says
le monde.
For God so loved the world.
Il a envoyé son fils.
And that he gave his only begotten son.
Afin que tous ceux qui
croient
en lui.
He lives in him.
Aient la vie éternelle.
May not perish but have eternal life.
La Noël.
Christmas.
C'est une histoire d'amour entre Dieu et ses créatures.
It's all about the history of God and love with his creature.
La Bible dit.
The Bible says.
Que nous avons tous péché.
All of us, we have sinned.
Et que nous méritons la mort.
And we deserve death.
Alors pour éviter cette mort.
And for not taking place in that death.
Dieu a fait son fils.
Has lost his son.
Un cadeau pour nous.
Given us a gift.
La vie de son fils.
The life of his son.
Un cadeau.
Just a gift.
Pour nous racheter de nos péchés.
To redeem us from sin.
Pour que nous puissions avoir la vie éternelle.
So that we can have eternal life.
Je vous recommande, vous qui connaissez déjà la Bible, pour enseigner cela à vos enfants.
I'm telling you, parents, you who know the Bible, to teach that to your kids.
Jean 3, verset 16.
John chapter 3, verse 16.
Amen.
Amen.
Voici pourquoi les hommes doivent aimer leurs frères.
This reason why. Men should love their wives.
Les enfants, apprenez l'amour. Voyez tout ce qu'ils vont vous donner. C'est parce que ils ont un cœur d'amour.
Children learn about love.
C'est une grâce.
Whatever they done for you, it will show you love. It's
si tu n'aimes pas ton frère, tu es du diable.
If you don't like your friend or your brother,
si tu fais des histoires à tes frères, tu es du diable.
If you do something wrong to your brother, you are not of God. You are of the devil.
Le diable va vous entraîner à l'enfer.
The devil will take you.
Mais vous n'avez pas besoin d'aller en enfer parce que Dieu a envoyé son fils, il a sacrifié à la croix.
You don't need to go to hell because God has given you, yes, given
pour
you
que
his
nous
son.
Ayons la vie.
He died on the cross to die.
Et tout ce qu'il nous recommande, c'est l'amour.
And whatever I want you to do is just love.
Celui qui n'aime pas son frère, tu es un menteur.
If you say you love
parce
God,
que
you a liar.
Dieu que tu ne vois pas, tu ne peux pas dire que tu l'aimes.
You don't see,
alors que ton frère qui est devant toi, tu le détestes.
When your brother who's near, you don't love him.
Aimez-vous les uns les autres.
You have to love each other.
Si vous aimez les uns les autres,
if you love each other,
Dieu va vous bénir. Bénis vos parents.
He's gonna bless you.
Nous sommes venus dans ce pays pas pour être derrière
we
les
have
hommes.
This country.
Alléluia. Beaucoup.
He loves you.
L'église nous a sont remplis d'amour.
The church leaders are ready.
Et ils nous offrent toujours la possibilité de nous réunir.
They are ready.
Et je voudrais que le peuple ivoirien comprenne cela. Vous aussi, allez-y à la maison partager ce passage, partager l'amour à vos frères et sœurs. C'est ce que Dieu nous demande. Soyez bénis et amusez-vous bien.
And have a good time.
Praise the Lord. All right, so maintenant on a une autre surprise pour vous. Are you guys ready for another surprise? Okay, this is the rule. When you hear this, I want to hear claps, okay? And I want to really shout. On va recevoir des jeunes filles très 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 talentueuses. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Thank you guys, I love it, I love the spirit. So leur nom c'est Munoz Angels. Can we have the Munoz Angels here? Remember the rules, remember the rules.
We've been called for to show His excellence. Hey, all I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, for I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what He says I am, when He says I am. I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what He says I am, when He says I am. I know who I am. I'm walking in power, I'm working miracles, I live the life of faith.
There we go. Now, part of the show, I'm going to need some volunteers from the audience to help me out with some of the tricks. But not right now, so put your hands down. But when we get a volunteer up here, we always clap our hands for the volunteer to let them know that we appreciate their help. Let's practice. Ready?
Yay!
Pretty good, pretty good. Let's see who can clap their hands the fastest. Let's see who can clap them the loudest. Clapping hard enough. All right. I need a volunteer from the audience. I like to start off with a girl volunteer. I believe that old saying, ladies first, boys get over it. Oh, I forgot to tell you, I need somebody that's sitting down with their hands raised. Is there a girl out there who wants to help me out? You want to help right here in the front? Come on up, give her a round of applause. We're gonna scoot forward. Stay right there. We're gonna scoot this forward a little bit. There we go. What is your name? What is it? Deborah. How old are you, Deborah? 6 years old. Are you married? No. Does your husband know you're not married? It's a trick question. There you go. Have you ever been a magician's assistant before? Never have. I will teach you everything you need to know. First, all my volunteers need to wear some sort of magic hat while they're helping me out. So we're gonna make Deborah a magic hat. Here we go, I got it over here. You know what this is? A dead worm, you're right, dead worm. No, it's not a dead worm, it's a long, skinny balloon. These are called pencil balloons because they're shaped like a pencil before you blow them up. They're really hard to blow up, so you stretch them like this, and ow. What's so funny about that? Blow it on the wrong end. Wow. All right, Deborah, hold on to that for me. Whoa! Where'd it go? Why did it fly away with? Oh, that's right, I forgot to tie it in a knot. That's the same reason that a doctor ties a knot in a baby's belly button when he's first born, so he doesn't go all the air comes out of him. You didn't know that? Not really. Don't go home and try to untie your baby brother's belly button, all right?
Mom, the magician said he'd fly away.
All right, here we go. Stretch it like this. That's not funny. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Okay. Now what? Tie it in a knot. That's right. We tie it in a knot. Now, should we use one long one or two short ones? You're holding. Ah! Not again. Where'd it go? Bring it up, our pizza. Bring it up here. Bring it up. Throw it up. Throw it up. All right. First rule when you make a mess, what do?
No.
You clean it up. That's right. We pick up our pieces. All right. My second rule is I always come prepared with an extra one. Just in case. All right. Here we go. I'm not going to snap my finger again. That's for sure. That's not funny. All right, tired of the night. Now, what were we going to do with this thing anyway? Oh, we're supposed to make a magic hat for you. Stand over here in front of the box. My handle's coming off. All right, stay there. First, we have to measure your head, Deborah, to make sure we get the right size, okay? We'll measure your head. And whoa, did anybody ever tell you you have a big head? Well, your head's not that big. I had the wrong size. I'm sorry. Hold on. There we go, that's much better. Okay, we'll give it the magic hat, then up here, the magic antenna. Not only does the antenna help her concentrate her powers, it helps me pick up Saturday morning cartoons too. Better viewing reception for the hat on. Now we're gonna decorate the hat with some beautiful fashion accessories. I left the beautiful ones at home, we're gonna use these. We'll tie these handkerchiefs in a tight knot. I say cannot because I don't know how to say not. Said what? No, I say cannot because I don't know how to say not.
Said
what?
Not.
I did not. Never mind, that's ridiculous. All right, stand back over here. At the end of your arms. As high as your nose and at the end of your arms. Good. On the count of three, it's gonna fly over his head and land in the bag. Here we go, ready? One, two, oh no, look over there. What's that? You saw me put it in the bag?
Yeah.
You didn't look over there when I told you to look over there? What a sneaky audience. Oh, wait a minute. Just a few minutes ago when I was teaching you the old handkerchief trick, I taught you that sometimes magicians distract your attention. Remember I said sometimes they make you look over here when you should be looking over there? Do you remember what I called that? Misdirection, right? I should have never given away my secret. I tell you what, we won't use misdirection. Let's use some other magic words. How about hocus pocus? Let's practice. Ready? Hocus pocus. All right, hold on to the bag again. I'm gonna put the block back where it started from. When I put it back, you count to three, everybody's gonna say hocus pocus. All right, you ready?
Wait till I get it out of here.
All right, ready? Count to three.
One, two, three.
Hold it still. We're going to do a long shot. I'm going to come over here. We're going to cover up the A, the B, the C. Remember that cannon I was telling you about? Here we go. Boom! What's missing? The B is gone. Reach down inside the bag. See if you caught the B. He's a bee catcher. Give him a big round of applause. And he goes back to his seat. We'll put that one away. And now, are you ready to see another trick with Clara? Here we go. Well, what do you think she's trying to be? What? Funny, Ryan. I didn't know she knew how to be a bunny rabbit. All right. This is Alex the bunny rabbit. Yeah. Now, Alex is part of two different kinds of bunnies. His mom was a California bunny. That's a kind of rabbit. And they're all white with blue eyes. But does Alex have blue eyes? No, he's got red eyes. His dad was a Dutch dwarf rabbit, and he was all black with red eyes. And so he got his red eyes like his dad, and he got black spots on him from some of his dad's coloring, and the rest of him's like his mom. You want to see him do his trick?
Yeah!
All right. You know how people teach their dogs? Roll over, fetch, and play dead. I taught him how to play dead. It's hard for rabbits. You have to hypnotize them. Look into my eyes. You are getting sleepy. Sleepy. That's silly. You are now in my power. We gotta be real quiet. Play that. Wake up, Alex. Give him a round of applause. All right. Now, after the magic show, anybody that wants to pet Alex, I'll bring him down, and you can pet, not right now, after the show. But here's the thing. Anytime you pet an animal, even if it's your own cat or dog, before you eat or do anything else, you should wash your hands, right? So that's your promise. You have to promise that if you're going to pet Alex, and Alex loves to be petted, he gets petted by kids all the time, that if, I know, it's not about your hands getting clean, it's about having the bunny rabbit fur on your fingers or stuff before you eat. Anytime you touch an animal, you should wash your hands afterwards, okay? So that's the agreement. All right, we're gonna put his cage back together. Here we go. And then we do another magic trick. I need another volunteer from the audience. There we go, Alex. Let's see. How about in the second row right here? Yeah, that's you, come on up. Give him a round of applause, yay! And over here. All right, what is your name? What is it? Samuel? Samuel, how old are you? Five, you really five? When I was your age, I was six. No one? Okay, never mind. All right, here we go. We're gonna get your magic hat for Samuel. Red with white stripes, there you go. Give him a round of applause. There you go. Now let's see, who knows what this is?
A bag.
Could be a shopping bag, could be a good, let's see, what else could it be? Could be a gift bag. Anything inside?
No.
Nothing on the inside. Can you hold onto the handles like that? One on each hand? All right, today we're not gonna use it as a shopping bag or a gift bag. Today we're gonna use it as a bird's nest. What do birds put inside their nest?
Eggs,
that's right. I need a magical egg. Did anybody bring a Macedonian dodo bird egg today? Macedonian dodo bird egg, anybody? Macedonian dodo birds have been extinct for thousands of years. They're like the dinosaurs. We don't have them anymore. But I happen to have the last existing Macedonian dodo bird egg.
Here it is. A Macedonian
dodo bird egg. I know it sounds like it's made of wood because it's petrified. Yeah, that's the thing. All right, we're gonna put that down in the nest. All right. Oh, you didn't know they laid square eggs? That's the thing with dodo birds. Macedonian dodo birds lived thousands of years ago in a place called Macedonia. They lived at the top of the highest mountain, and they always laid their eggs right on the ground. They didn't even build a nest. And every time they laid a round egg, it would roll all the way to the bottom of the hill. So they started laying square eggs. And now you know why they're extinct. They called them dodo birds because they would let their eggs roll away. Then they started laying square eggs. They stopped calling them dodo birds. You know what they called them? Ooh-ah birds. Ooh-ah. Because that's the sound they would make when they laid a square egg. They would go, ooh-ah. I think I'd make that sound if I laid any egg, wouldn't you? Ooh-ah. Now, I happen to have the last existing Macedonian dodo bird egg carton. Thousands of years ago, when the kids in Macedonia went to the supermarket with their mom and dad, they would buy their eggs in these cartons. Now we have space for two eggs, but we only have one egg left. So we're just going to use one side. Okay, will you cut that out? Would you excuse me for just a minute?
We're just gonna use one side!
Sometimes you can't hear. All right, I'm gonna put the block inside there. You're gonna, the egg in there, you're gonna count to three. Everybody's gonna say, Alakazam. Let's practice. Alakazam. Oh, you're gonna need your hands. Can you put the whole bag up here on the table for me? Your job. That's good. That's fine. You get to hold on to this, okay? Now, you're going to count to three. Everybody's going to say Alakazam. You wave the stick around, point it, and tap it one time, okay? Are you ready? Wait till I get it here. Get this out. Okay, count to three. Loud so they can hear you.
One, two, three.
Alakazam! Yeah! Hold on. Tap it on the top. Perfect. Watch. It's going to disappear. It's gone. Completely vanished. Ha ha. Disappeared. No, put it on that side. Oh, you want to see the other side? Okay, I'll show you. It's gone. Completely gone. Disappeared. Ha ha. Oh, you think I tipped it over and went to the other side? Okay, I won't tip it over. Watch. I'm going to keep it flat. It's not here, and it's not there. It's completely gone. See? It's completely gone. Oh, you want me to open both doors at the same time? And then you'll be happy? I want everybody to be happy. Fine, both doors, same time. Everybody's happy. All right, there we go. All of it. You mean?
All of it.
This door?
All of it.
And this door, and this door. Go ahead, open that door. Wait a minute, where'd it go? You think it went back to the nest? Reach inside the nest, see if it's in there. Pull it out, show it to everybody. He found it. Give him a big round of applause. Thank you, sir. Stay right here for a second. Wait. He gets some big money. All right. Give him a big round of applause. Yeah. I need another volunteer from the audience. Okay, we got the big girls want to play too, huh? All right. How about it though? Right there. That's you in the white. Yeah, you. Yeah, come on. In the white. She's coming. Yeah, her. Sorry. All right, what's your name? Soraya, how old are you? 12 years old? What a coincidence. My name was Soraya when I was a little girl. I was never a little girl. I did have a big sister, and one year for Halloween, she made me dress like a pretty princess. That is not funny. Okay, it's a little funny. All right, here we go. We get Soraya magic hat. Look at that. It's green with black spots. Red and white stripes for Soraya. Ow! I'm sorry about that. I forgot all about that one. That's my Halloween hat. We don't want that. Here we go. We'll make our new hat with my ninja skills. That's right. Skills of a ninja. Like a ninja turtle. Hiya! 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 I have a black belt in origami. Hiya! Hiya! I can prove it. Only the black belts can do the combination hat. Hiya! The sombrero. Or a pirate hat. Arr. I be Soraya, the pirate of the Caribbean. Cut off me leg and call me Peggy. Arr. You didn't see the one with Peggy the pirate, did you? Because it be rated R. All right, never mind. Set it right over here. There you go. Face the audience. I got three colors. All right. You can scoot back just a little bit. There we go. What color is that?
Red.
What color is that?
White.
It's red. All right, hold the white one in that hand. Hold the blue one in the other hand. And hold the red one in the other hand. You only have two hands? Don't laugh. She only has two hands. I have three hands. One, two, three. See? Told you. Uh-huh. One, two. I left the other one at home. I did. I brought the wrong ones. These two don't match.
What?
Ah! Hate it when that happens.
All right, here we go. I need a bag. Here we go. Aha!
What's inside the bag? Nothing. Nothing in there. 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 We're going to make an American flag. We need the magic words. Presto change-o. Let's try it. Ready? Presto change-o. All right, so we all stand together. Soraya's going to count to three. Sorry. When she counts to three, everybody say presto change-o. Count to three.
One.
Loud so they can hear you.
One.
Presto change up! Alright, wave your hand over the bag. Wave your hand and the other hand. Wait.
Give me that.
Alright, here we go. Wave your hand. Alright, here we have the American. Whoa. That's not funny.
Wave your hand, wave your hand.
Here we have the American. I have a flag. Three cheers for the red, white, and. Blue. Wait a minute. We put the blue in too late. It didn't stick. Maybe we can glue it on. No, what's missing? Stars. We're missing stars. Okay, count to three. We're going to go for the stars.
One, two, three.
Presto change. Wave your hand over the bag. Here we have the... Oh, no. Tell you what, sometimes this happens. Sometimes it overheats. We got warm light. Overheat. So I brought my own air conditioning. Ancient Chinese air conditioning. Ooh, yeah. That feels good right there. What? I am not bald. No, I am not bald. I happen to be follically challenged. Take the bag, wave it over here three times. Hold on to it, open it up, wave it like that three times. Hold on to it, open it up, wave it like that three times. Hold on to it, you got it. Open it up, wave it over here. Okay, then wave it like this. One, two, three. Just like that. Okay, hold on. Open it. What'd you do to my fan? That's the only fan in my fan club. Look what happened. Okay, maybe you can fix it. Take a deep breath. And then blow. Deep breath. And blow. Like that. Deep breath. And blow. Good. Blow. She fixed it. All right, give her a round of applause. Yay! All right, it's fixed. Hold it at the end like this. Doesn't matter which end you hold. You just hold it like that. And then you wave it over the bag. The bag disappeared. Oh, the bag disappeared. Okay, wave it like that three times. Hold on to it. Open it up. Wait. Do you do that to everything you touch? Hate to see your toy box. All right, I got it. We'll use the magic wand instead, okay? Take the magic wand. Wave it over here three times. Hold on to it. Wave it like that. Well, what'd you do? Looks like a jump rope for Munchkins. We're jumping rope for the ladder by leg, the ladder by leg, the ladder by leg. Blow on the wand there. Okay, fix it. Grab it like that three times. Hold on to it. Wave it. Okay, you hold it like this. Wave it over here. It never bends. It never breaks. It never falls apart. What are you talking about? Oh. You have to keep your eyes on it. Never take your eyes off of it. Hold on to it. Don't take your eyes off it. Wait a minute. Okay. I got something in here. Here we go. All right. We're going to take the magic wand. Wave it over here three times. What are you doing? Put that one in your left hand. Hold this one in your right hand. All right, wave them like that. This one to your chin. Now wave them all at the same time. Wave them, wave them. Wave. Not working. We have too many magic wands. Okay, pick a wand, anyone you want.
Pick me, pick me, pick me, pick me, pick me, pick me. Pick me! You don't like me?
I'm all alone.
You call him one. Okay, don't listen to
the
voices. Anyone you want. Okay, we'll put the rest away. Alright, let's see what we have in the bag. The red, the white. We forgot to say presto change. Alright, count to three.
One, two,
three. Presto change. Wave the wand over the bag. No, use your left hand. Left hand. Wait, I see stars. I think it worked. Look, stars and stripes. Alright! Look at that. There we go. Is that right?
No.
No. We have stripes where the stars are supposed to be. Stars where the stripes are supposed to be. We're getting close. Hold it in your left hand. Count to three.
One, two, three.
Presto change. Wave the wand over the bag. All right. Tap it on the top of the wand. Not three times. Give me that. Did I say tap it three times?
No.
No. I said tap it. If you tap it, American flag. You tap it three times. Snake in the bag. Reach in, pull out the snake. You made him. You get him out of there. Look, he's dead. Pull out the dead snake. Hey. Stars, stripes, everything in the right order. Give her a big round of applause. Excellent job. Here we go. You get some big money. All right. Now, I want to explain something. This is close to the end of the show. In a minute, we're going to bring Bunny Rabbit down, and you can say, but we've been having a lot of fun saying silly magic words. These magic words don't have any power. You do know that. Although, the original abracadabra, that's a Hebrew word for as I say, so let it be. Not many people know that. That actually is a Hebrew word from the Bible. But we don't say any magic words. The only words that I believe have power are the words of Jesus Christ. If we say in Jesus' name, now that's something we can trust. You can't trust abracadabra. You can't trust presto chango alakazam, but you can trust in Jesus' name. Now I don't do a whole lot of shows in magic in churches, but I do some for my own church and other things. And so I want you to know that there are certain things, words that we can trust, but they aren't silly magic words, okay? And another word that you should use all the time are please and thank you. Those work a lot of magic with your mom and dad if you say please and thank you. So those are really the only magic words we use. So I have one thing, since everybody helped me say the magic words and you are a great audience, anybody that wants the big money can have some of the big money. All right, we're gonna have that with that. Here we go. I got big money for everybody. Now, can I have a couple of my dancers over here. Would you guys help me hand them out to the kids, okay? Get one apiece, guys, one apiece. I got more if that's not enough. There we go. Here you go. Well, there's not enough. There we go. Hand them out. Okay, now I'm going to pack this case down and then I'll bring out the bunny rabbit and we'll put him over to the side. Any of the kids that want to pet the bunny rabbit, like I said, you can come over in just a minute, okay?
Here we go.
Okay. Okay, I'll bring him over to the side. Alright. Okay. Alright, you guys get your big money. Anybody that wants to come over and pet the bunny rabbit, Alex, can come on and do that. Thank you very much.
Alright. Give a round of applause for Lani Magic. Did you guys have fun? Alright. So before we open the food for the kids, I would like to introduce to the parents, Mrs. Suzanne Kwasi. She's joining First with AIT to promote a foundation which is looking to raise money for for scholarship for kids back home in Ivory Coast. So I'm gonna introduce her and let her come here and give us a little overview of what her organization is. And you're going to hear a little bit more in the upcoming weeks about her organization and how we can help fund the education of young girls back home.
Good evening, everyone. Bonsoir. I'm not going to try to speak in French because that may fail. My name is Susan Quasi, and I'm recently moved to Houston. I have a young ladies who are going to school. The school that we support right now is Lycée Moderne d'Abobo in Abobo, and we've also worked in Tiasene. So every year we provide, okay. I don't have any good luck tonight. Okay. Every year we support, we pay by private donations. So I have with me a brochure, and I also have donation cards. All my contact information is on there. If you want to learn more about the organization. We are a 501c3 nonprofit charitable organization, so we are also tax deductible. So that's what we do. So thank you for your attention, and feel free to ask me any questions.
Excellent. So I would like to introduce Bintu Indri. She's one of our sisters. She has a really special product to show you. Those are dolls with African features, dark skin, with fabrics that are coming from home. I think this is a great way to show our young girls that they can play with dolls that look like them. I'm in full support of what she's doing. So AIT asked her to come and introduce her product. So Bintu, come here. Round of applause, please.
All right, so I guess on va faire ça en français. Merci Kevin, tu as déjà introduit tout le produit. Juste pour présenter, j'ai deux petites filles en fait. Donc j'ai une de 2 ans et une de 4 ans. Et avec le temps, vivant ici aux États-Unis, j'ai réalisé en fait que la majorité des jouets que j'avais pour elles étaient des jouets avec des features qui étaient blancs. Et je ne suis pas raciste, je n'ai pas de souci avec, mais je voulais en fait que mes filles soient à l'aise avec leur peau. Et pensant à moi-même, à ma propre enfance, j'ai réalisé que la plupart des poupées que j'avais étaient blanches. Et en fait, ça a causé en fait pas un complexe, mais en fait une envie de ressembler à ces poupées blanches. Donc ça a commencé avec défriser les cheveux, essayer de ressembler vraiment à ce que en fait on mettait au devant de moi. Et donc je me suis dit qu'en fait, en créant ces poupées qui ressemblaient plus à nos filles, on les ferait se sentir mieux dans leur peau. Donc c'est par là que j'ai commencé, avec la poupée que j'ai appelée Princesse Aou. Donc en fait, Aou, c'est le nom du village de ma fille, Victoria. Et en fait, je voulais que cette poupée en fait, soit pour elle un symbole de ce que je voulais qu'elle soit quand elle soit grande. Donc je voulais qu'elle soit confiante dans sa peau. Je voulais qu'elle soit fière de son héritage et je voulais aussi que par là, elle soit OK avec ce qu'elle est. Donc, en fait, quand j'ai commencé Aou, j'ai commencé ça pour mes filles, mais en fait, en les vendant, j'ai vu beaucoup d'intérêt sur les social media. Et donc, j'ai commencé à les vendre. Donc, en les vendant, en fait, on les vend sur Amazon, sur Etsy et sur eBay. Et j'ai différents modèles et j'ai aussi les commercialisés en Côte d'Ivoire. Donc, je suis dans le bac si vous avez des questions.
On va ouvrir le buffet pour les enfants et pendant ce temps, on va faire sortir les cadeaux. J'espère que tout le monde a enregistré ses enfants à l'entrée pour s'assurer qu'on a un cadeau pour votre enfant. Donc si vous ne l'avez pas fait, vous pouvez venir à la table ici et on s'assurera que vous êtes enregistré. Est-ce qu'il y a quelqu'un dans la salle qui n'a pas enregistré ses enfants? Tout le monde a enregistré? D'accord, donc on va se diriger vers le bas. Les enfants, vous pouvez continuer le face painting et aller à l'école. Gabriel, attendez, guys, hold on. Maintenant, ça c'est Junior Côté, c'est qui Junior Côté? Take your time, bring your present. Come on, y'all. Bring your gift. Are you guys ready?
You don't have to open it. Okay,
you stand in line like you're going to school, like you're taking a school picture.
Are you John?
No, no, she looks like John. What is that? Si.
Evan, assieds-toi.
Oh my gosh, crazy picture! Okay, how about 1, 2, 3, yay! 1, 2, 3, yay!